Lord be with you.
And also with you.
Please be seated. Good morning.
Good morning.
Let's try that again. Good morning. Do we have any announcements this morning? I know there are a couple in your bulletin of note. Remembrance Sunday next Sunday, followed by a pasta lunch. All welcome. November 10th is Communion Sunday, followed by Munchies for Missions. And also there is the Bible seminar, second in the series, coming up on November the 9th. You do need to register for that. There's no cost, but it's just so we know how many people are going to be attending. I also have just a very quick announcement. Some of you may know that I sing in with the Brant County Singers, and our Christmas concert combined with the Brant Men of Song, believe it or not, we're talking Christmas already, will take place on Saturday, December the 7th at 7 o'clock at Hope Christian Reformed Church in Brantford. So I'll put this up on the bulletin board. Please stand for our opening liturgy. God, we gather as your servants, shaped by the faithfulness of those who went before us and taught us the name of Jesus. In Christ, you call us together to praise your name and serve your world in his name. With the kindness of your Spirit, feed the roots of our faith and renew our vision for the church in this generation. Fill us with courage and confidence. Please be seated. And I neglected to say welcome to anyone who hasn't worshiped with us before. Welcome to our friends online. And if you don't get it, or you know someone who would like to see the service later in the day, you can just get it on YouTube. Let us join in our prayers of adoration and confession. God of mystery and blessing, we speak without knowledge, we grasp without looking at the consequences, we boast without cause, we speak comfort without true compassion. Forgive our ignorance when we look at what others have without seeing what they have lost. Forgive our self-absorption when we focus on our desires and ignore the needs of others. Lord of love and mercy, you are the source of every good and perfect gift. But we confess our gifts to you are less than perfect. We honor you when it fits into our schedules. We forget that your love should set our priorities and pursue our own desires. Forgive our wavering hearts and reawaken our commitment to you. friends, we are promised that those who abide in love abide in God, and God abides in them. Claim your hope in this good news. God's perfect love abides in you through Jesus Christ our Lord. Thanks be to God. Our opening hymn is found at Voices United 296. This is God's wondrous world. Please stand as you're able. Okay, so who have we got this morning that would like to participate with me, young at heart? Do you guys want to come up and help me with something? So I wish they would have put the title on this slide. Is there a title on the next slide? No, eh? Okay. So it should have said, where do you see God? So that's our question. Where do you see God? Okay, and I'm going to come over there with this microphone. Is it on? Push what? Oh. Oh, yes, okay. So I'm going to come over here. And here's what we're going to do this morning, because this is kind of a little bit of a trick question. I didn't do it on purpose. It just happened that way. But where do you see God? Do you see God? We don't see God, do we? Because God is not here. God is everywhere else. So here's what I want to do this morning. I'm going to give each of you an opportunity to take this microphone and go out here into the congregation and ask someone, where do they see God at work in our world? Can you do that? You can go together if you want. You don't have to be frightened. It's okay. Her eyes got really, really big, like, oh dear. Sophie, do you want to start maybe and pick someone and just go out? So we're going to ask, what are we going to ask?
Where do you see God at work?
Go for it. Go ask someone.
Where do you see God at work?
I see God at work in all the beautiful colors in the trees in the fall. They've just been lovely. So you can tell that his hand has touched them.
You want Sophie to go ask again? Maybe she should come and ask you. Okay, ask
Where do you see God at work?
With my pets.
Right up close.
With my pets.
Where do you see God at work?
Everywhere. He's part of all that we do.
Want to ask one more person, Sophie?
Where do you see God at work?
Sorry, what did you ask me?
Where do you see God at work?
Where do I see God at
work?
I see God at work in the kindness that people do to each other.
Where do you see God at work?
In the children.
So it's a really hard question to answer, and that's the whole point. Today we're going to have a piece of scripture in Mark, and it talks about a blind man named Bartimaeus. And we're going to talk about that today, but I think you might have something special planned. They're doing stone soup. And they all look like, and look at Shannon and go, what's that? Don't forget, we're all going to ask the children what they did during playground making stone soup, what it was, okay? And we're going to remember, where is God at work in the world, all right? Thank you for your help.
Please join with me in the prayer for understanding. O God, as we hear your word read and interpreted today, touch us with its healing power so that we are able to follow your Son, our Savior and friend. Amen. The scripture reading from the Old Testament is taken from the book of Job, chapter 42, verses 1 to 6 and verses 10 to 17. In this, Job acknowledges God's power and Job's fortunes are restored. Then Job replied to the Lord, I know that you can do all things. No purpose of yours can be thwarted. You asked, who is this that obscures my plans without knowledge? Surely I spoke of things I did not understand, things too wonderful for me to know. You said, listen now, and I will speak. I will question you, and you shall answer me. My ears had heard of you, but now my eyes have seen you. Therefore I despise myself and repent in dust and ashes. After Job had prayed for his friends, the Lord restored his fortunes and gave him twice as much as he had before. All his brothers and sisters and everyone who had known him before came and ate with him in his house. They comforted and consoled him over all the trouble the Lord had brought on him, and each one gave him a piece of silver and a gold ring. The Lord blessed the latter part of Job's life more than the former part. He had 14,000 sheep, 6,000 camels, 1,000 yoke of oxen, and 1,000 donkeys. And he also had 7 sons and 3 daughters. The first daughter he named Jemima, the second Keziah, and the third Karen Habuk. Nowhere in all the land were there found women as beautiful as Job's daughters, and their father granted them an inheritance along with their brothers. After this, Job lived 140 years. He saw his children and their children to the fourth generation. And so Job died, an old man and full of years. Another Old Testament reading is from Psalm 34. Nate will play it first, and then the choir will sing the response, and then all of us will sing. I will bless God at all times. God's praise will continually be in my mouth. My soul will glory in God. The humble will hear and be glad. Oh, magnify God with me. Let us exalt God's name together. I sought God who answered me and freed me from all my fears. Look to the Most High and let your light shine and your face will not be ashamed. This poor soul cried out, and God heard, and saved me from all my troubles.
Taste and see.
Your angel, O God, keeps guard over those who fear you and delivers them. Taste and see that our God is good. Happy are those who take refuge in God. Fear God, you who are the saints, for those who fear God lack nothing. Lions suffer and go hungry, but those who seek God lack no good thing. Come, my children, and listen to me. I will teach you the fear of God. Which of you delights in life and desires many days to enjoy prosperity? Keep your tongue from evil, your lips from speaking lies. Turn away from evil and do good. Seek peace and pursue it. God's eyes are upon the righteous, God's ears open to their cry. God's face is set against evildoers to blot out their remembrance from the earth. The righteous cry out, and God hears them and rescues them from all their troubles. God is near to the brokenhearted and saves those who are crushed in spirit. Many are the afflictions of the righteous, but God sets them free from every sorrow. God guards every bone in their body. Not one of them will be broken. Evil brings death to the wicked. Those who hate the righteous will be condemned. But you, God, redeem the life of your servants. None who take refuge in you are condemned. The New Testament reading is taken from the book of Mark, chapter 10, verses 46 to 52. It's about the healing of Bartimaeus and when blind Bartimaeus receives his sight. Then they came to Jericho. As Jesus and his disciples, together with a large crowd, were leaving the city, a blind man, Bartimaeus, which means son of Timaeus, was sitting by the roadside begging. When he heard that it was Jesus of Nazareth, he began to shout, Jesus, Son of David, have mercy on me. Many rebuked him and told him to be quiet, but he shouted all the more, Son of David, have mercy on me. Jesus stopped and said, call him. So they called to the blind man, cheer up, on your feet, he's calling you. Throwing his cloak aside, he jumped to his feet and came to Jesus. What do you want me to do for you? Jesus asked him. The blind man said, Rabbi, I want to see. Go, said Jesus, your faith has healed you. Immediately he received his sight and followed Jesus along the road. The word of the Lord. Thanks be to God.
This morning, the meditation is called Sound, Sight, and Faith, and there are some excerpts from Michael K. Marsh and his Let Me See Again. A new bride, just home from the honeymoon, was preparing a special meal with ham and lots of extras. The young husband was surprised when his wife cut off apparently two good ends of the ham before it went into the oven. Why did you do that? He asked. That's the way my mother always fixed a ham, she replied. On a visit to her folks, he asked his mother-in-law about it and heard, that's the way my mother always cooked a ham. The young groom then made a special trip to the grandmother's house to hear her explanation. Son, that's the only way the ham will fit into my pan. Do you respond to life the way others have? Or do you make your own decisions? Do you do something because that's the way it was shown to you, like the new bride preparing a ham? Or do you look at the overall picture and consider different ways to approach it? We live in a world where things are thrown at us with lightning speed. You can find anything you want on social media or Google or on television, and the list goes on and on. And every reporter has an agenda. Ask five people who witness an accident to give an account of what happened, and you'll get five different stories, even if they're all trying to be objective. Every retelling of a story has a purpose. It's true of current events, and it's true in biblical narratives. And each time we read scripture, we may find a different answer. So let's look at the Gospel of Mark this morning with an open mind, and not make it only about physical blindness and sight. We often hear this story and think of blindness and seeing in their outward forms. But what about inward blindness and seeing? What about what is being offered and received? The sounds around him and the faith exuding from him. I think this story is bigger than outward and physical blindness or seeing. I think it's a universal story that every one of us experiences, even if our vision is 20/20. So let's consider a few questions. Do you ever feel like you are in the dark? I don't mean someone turned off the lights around you, but that the light within you is no longer shining. I'm talking about those times when you feel lost and you can't see a way forward. You're confused. There's no clarity. Maybe the answers and beliefs that once lit your way no longer illuminate the path you're on. You stumble and fumble your way through life, not sure where you're going. Or maybe it's the darkness of fear. Maybe grief, loss, and sorrow have darkened your life. Maybe shadows from your past, shadows of guilt, regret, failure, disappointment. Mimic your every move, and no matter how fast you run, the shadow is still there. I wonder if that's what it was like for Bartimaeus. Do you ever feel like you're sitting on the roadside of life? Do you ever feel like everyone except you has it all figured out and is going somewhere? I'm going to shake my head, yes. I'm talking about those times when it feels like life is passing us by and we aren't getting anywhere. We feel stuck, more like a spectator of life than a participant. We do things because that's what's expected of us, and that's just the way it has been done before. Maybe it feels like your life has been turned upside down. Maybe it feels like you don't have any place to be and no one to miss you if you're not there. Maybe you've been sidelined by loneliness, being the outsider, or offering a voice others don't want to hear. I wonder if that's what it was like for Bartimaeus. I know these are things that I have experienced and I lived and have been able to move forward from, but only because of my faith and belief that in all things God works for the good of those who love him, who have been called according to God's purpose. Romans 8:2-8. In 2014, I moved to Rockwood from Eastern Ontario. It was a time in my life when a lot of changes were happening. I was in the midst of my 17-year marriage ending, moving across the province, and starting a new job. I was leaving behind everything that I had known and loved to come to a place I had only visited occasionally. It was exciting, but also very scary. I was alone. It was during this time that I lost my voice and my joy of singing, and my faith wavered. Do you ever feel like the well has run dry and you have nothing in reserve? It's those times when life overwhelms us and we wonder how or if we'll get by. It's not just that we don't have enough. We start wondering if we are enough. I wonder if that's what it was like for Bartimaeus. It was during this time in my life that I knew I needed to meet new people and become involved in something, anything. So I returned to church and joined the congregation at Rockwood United. It was wonderful meeting new people and worshiping with them, but it wasn't enough. I was still wavering and wondering and searching. I couldn't see beyond where I was until I decided to join them on a mission trip to Guatemala. My goal of the trip was to see with my own eyes exactly what poverty looked like. Not what it looked like on TV, because, you know, who knows for sure what they show is actually happening. What I found there and the impact it had on me changed me forever. Well, I could see with my own eyes what was going on, and it gave me a truth. I found that I was also seeing beyond the circumstances they were faced with and living in. I found a people so rich in faith, it changed how I saw God, the world, myself, and others. It changed and strengthened my belief in God, my joy in all things, and it gave me back my singing voice. This period in my life, when everything changed, while it may seem like it happened in the blink of an eye, it actually spanned over 4 years. When have you been Bartimaeus? What happened? And what have you done with that experience? Or better yet, what has it done with you? Jesus asked Bartimaeus, what do you want me to do for you? Bartimaeus says, "My teacher, let me see again." I don't think blind Bartimaeus could see what or who was coming his way that day he sat on the roadside begging. The most he could do was to be faithful to his darkness, to not run away, to cry out in hope. And maybe that's true for you and me. We sit in our darkness begging, and then one day something begins to come into focus. Things start to look different. We catch a glimpse of a new life. We have an insight about ourselves. We begin to see things differently. At the beginning, I asked two questions. Do you respond to life the way others have, or do you make your own decisions? Do you do something because that's the way it was shown to you, like the new bride preparing a ham? Or do you look at the overall picture and consider different ways to approach it? What if changing our lives and our world begins with changing how we see, how we listen, what we do with what we see and hear, and how we live out our faith? Like Bartimaeus, we should rely on God's promises rather than visible evidence. For I know the plans I have for you, declares the Lord, plans to prosper you and not to harm you, plans to give you hope and a future. Jeremiah 29:11. Amen. And we're going to respond with the hymn, Open My Eyes That I May See, found at Voices United 371. Please stand as you're able.
Today, on this Memorial Sunday, let us take time to remember those that we have lost over the past year. With this single red rose, we remember Edna Ruth Brown, my apologies, a much-loved member of Knox. With this vase of white roses, we remember others who we have held close in our hearts, but are no longer here with us today. May the love of Christ surround each one of us with his peace.
Let us pray. Just and merciful God, we turn to you in hope and gratitude. When the world around us seems troubling, we are grateful for your steadfast love. Thank you for your Spirit at work in all times and places, calling out the best in your people showing us when we must repent, opening paths to reconciliation where we have offended. With the proclamation of your prophets and the compassion of Jesus in mind, may we seek your justice and know your mercy day by day. We pray for justice for the earth. Protect those creatures and communities at risk from the effects of dramatic disasters and incremental changes in the climate. Open our eyes to see how we can live more responsibly and change our hearts to know we must. We pray for justice among the nations. Create more generous sharing of resources between countries with good harvests and those depleted by famine, where resources are extracted for export. Protect brave advocates for fair wages and environmental protection. And where there is aggression and intimidation between nations, raise up the willingness to make peace and settle differences fairly. We pray for justice in our court systems. Guide those who judge, prosecute, or defend to serve with integrity, that those who are accused may receive fair trials, and that those who have been wronged are restored to fullness of life. Grant those who are convicted humane treatment, so that your spirit may lead them to rehabilitated potential. We pray for justice in the workplace. May those who work for others be treated with dignity and earn a fair wage. May all who create that work earn a fair return. Create equity and respect between those of different backgrounds and identities, and guide young people to opportunities to develop their gifts. God, we all need some kinds of healing in our lives. We remember before you those struggling with illness of body, mind, or spirit, those waiting for diagnosis or treatment, and all whose health challenges are invisible to others. Your spirit prays within us, O God, even when we cannot find the right words. So hear us this day, and answer in ways that encourage and change the world for the good. For the sake of Jesus Christ, who taught us this prayer, saying together, our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power and the glory, forever and ever. Amen. The scriptures speak of God's mercy, reversing the suffering of those who turn to God. As we give our gifts to God, let us be thankful for the strength God gives us to face our challenges. And trust we can help others face theirs when we reach out in Jesus' name. The offering will now be received. gracious God, we bring our offering in gratitude for all that makes our lives good, even in uncertain times. Bless these gifts with your spirit and use them through the ministry and mission of our church to touch lives in need of your goodness.
In Jesus' name.
Amen.
Amen.
We'll join together in Be Thou My Vision, Found a Voice, United 642, verses 1, 2, and 4. Bless the Lord continually.
Look to God and be radiant.
And let God's praises flow through your lives.
And may the God who made you, the Christ who mends you, and the Spirit who brings you life,
bless and keep you now and always.
Amen.
Amen.